Hey, are you there?
Listen to this.
News.
Music.
Poetry.
Drama.
Interviews.
Commercials.
And variety shows are all beautifully packaged in one piece. And represented on the number one radio, FX1 Radio.
FX1 Radio.
Stay with us.
Stay with us.
Stay with us.
Stay with us.
2 minutes to seven in Bamenda, Cameroon. From where? Our reporter, Cynthia Wancha, will be joining us in just a couple of seconds. And so, no school, no learning. That has been the situation in Bamenda. And of course, no court sessions. Activities remain grounded both in education and the legal sector. Cameroon, west of the Mungo. And teachers and lawyers are expressing discontent over typical Anglo-Saxon systems, which they say suffer under the unbearable weight of overriding Francophone systems. And as they call for a redress of the situation by staying away from classrooms and courtrooms, civilians took to the streets of Bamenda yesterday in protest marches. And they were also demanding other things and better conditions. So there are reports that there has been deployments of troops in Bamenda today. Cynthia Wancha now joins us for details. Cynthia, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. I think it's been a while. It's good to be on the program live again. Of course, like I said, when I have exactly 7 o'clock, Bamenda is back across Cameroon. And like Cynthia said, a lot has happened in Bamenda within the 2 days. Initially, we had just our lawyers who had gone on an indefinite strike demanding for a stop to the marginalization of common law subsistence. They were demanding for equal recognition of civil law as well as common law. Of course, I'm just reminding you that Cameroon is a bilingual county. While the lawyers were on this strike, the teachers had equally indicated that on the 21st of November 2016, they too will take to the streets. But their strike was not a student, excuse me. It was a sit down strike where they called on parents to keep their children home, and they equally called on teachers or principals of schools to ensure that schools do not open us from the 21st. The teachers have a whole lot that they are demanding from the government. Initially, the teachers had cried that the Francophones had taken over almost everything within the interesting regions of Cameroon. We have the University of Bamenda that was created in 2010. It's gone down to the University of Bamenda in Bamenda to find that almost 70% of the administrators or staff of that institution are French-speaking. So what is in the teachers' training schools, you have a greater majority of them being children or students who have come from the Francophone schools. These are students that have studied all their life right up to their basic teaching in the French language, and then they come right here. And since Cameroon has been a country where entrance into some of these institutions is not on merit, but on the basis of who is having what, how much you have in your pocket, or who you know within the institution, most of them were there. Most of them were sent on teaching practice to secondary schools where they go there, they teach the language in English that the students personally don't understand. The teachers, the syndicates, the trade teachers had been crying and asked the government to send the students to go teach in French institutions of learning and allow those who had studied in English to teach in the English learning institution. Government had earlier on promised that they were going to deploy these students to French speaking areas and as well as those from English speaking areas, but nothing had been done about it. So the teacher said, enough is enough. They want a stop to eat. So they had planned for 21st of November that they were going for this sit down strike. Unfortunately, I don't know if I should say unfortunately or fortunately yesterday, there is this comedian who works for a local radio station here in Bamenda, Bakwa FM. He took to the street yesterday with the coffin to the Liberty Square. And the Liberty Square, it got that name from the 1990s when the Social Democratic Front Party was launched in Cameroon, and several persons lost their lives there. That place had been known as the Liberty Square. He was exactly at that spot with a car and a coffin. He got into his coffin and said, today, yesterday, that was the very yesterday that he will be killed and buried in that coffin. That he wants to stand against what the Bamenda City Council is doing. Currently in Bamenda, we have water topics, the water crisis. Then we have this Chinese company that have for some months now been digging roads that they want to put pipes to ensure that it's a process to get water running in Bamenda. People are angry because they're digging up this road. When they do it and put the pipe, they don't maintain the road in the state in which they're made. So people are, the roads are bound to, they're bound to have potholes. In fact, the sanitation condition of the town, it's not been fair. There's traffic. Sometimes roads are blocked. People get to walk late. Students get to school late because of this work that is ongoing. So this was the main grievance of this young man yesterday. I'm saying that he wants the city council to stop doing what they are doing. It's actually the second time that this comedian has taken to that same spot. The first time when he took to that, organized a protest, he was protesting against the fact that the city council has hired people to clear the commercial avenue instead of city family change. That day was like, but the one of them is something else. And before we had pulled this huge crowd, we now took to the city council where, unfortunately, when they got there, the government manager was not on seat, they met other officials. And while they got there, they were already called, the gendarmes, the police, who were all over the place. They now asked him to come in for a dialogue with the officials of the city council. He now went in and presented a series of other grievances that the city council is not doing what is expected of them, that they want the government delegates to start the working to resign. And he's an institution of Bamenda, but he's not bringing development to this town in a way that when he can find himself to say that I think based on I think that when our government delegates to Bamenda City Council. So when this guy got there, all of a sudden, they got into a violent. They got into a fight with the men, the troops that were there. They shattered glasses, destroyed the defense of the Bamenda City Council. They moved from there out to the streets. Bamenda's streets were blocked, cars were burned. Circulation within town became difficult. People now had to just go within quarters to get to their houses. That is how it happened the whole yesterday. There was tear gas to disperse the population right up to midnight. 11:30, 2:30 a.m. It was still not, the situation had not come. Then this morning, at least people were able to get to work, but before 10 a.m., it was protest again. Roads were still being blocked. This people were protesting. And of course, there are some idle ones who have taken the opportunity of this situation. They have injured people property. They even block roads and ask people to pay some money before they can open the road and allow them to pass. There were rumors yesterday that there were the teachers who had incited all of this. But I must say that the teachers had opted earlier on for a sit-down strike. They had not indicated that they were going to the streets to protest. So the thing escalated yesterday. And while all of this was happening, the governor of the Northwest region called the leaders of trade unions organizations here in Bamenda, called the leaders of the Catholic Church, that's the archbishop as well as the moderator of the Presbyterian Church in Cameroon. He had a meeting with them yesterday. The teachers told their leaders their grievances and said they have been saying this government knows. So this they came to an agreement with the governor that the governor assured them that he was going to see into their problems, turning forward to the Yaoundé and ensuring that they can get to a table to negotiate. But these teachers have proved that if they have to be any negotiation, they do not want the Minister of Secondary Education or Higher Education to be part of that negotiation. That they want other persons to be on that table, but not the Minister of Education. Well, that's how Bamenda is at the moment. A few years ago, I was just driving home, and it's not easy. There are troops that have been deployed from Yaoundé, from Douala, from Bafoussam. As I heard this, I got this DVD because I was off station to actually see that and hear the indicator that people should try to get home. They do not want to see people in groups anywhere. People have been arrested. They had equally indicated that some persons have lost their life. I'm still to confirm that the situation is really not easy. I'm getting information to it's a little bit figure. Well, aside from what is actually happening in Bamenda, I was able to get to one of the leaders of the teachers trade union, that is of the French period, the trade union for the French period at school, Mr. Apple Tifford. In an interview that I got that was going to be bringing to our listeners, and he was able to explain their grievances and where they are at the moment with the strike. It's 2 days now, no schools. Schools have been shut down. Even the ones that attempted to open yesterday, they were seriously warned to close their doors and go back home. We're going to be listening to that interview with Mr. Apu and Stephen Wayne, who will tell throw more light on their grievances, where we are at the moment. And he's also going to do an appraisal of how the situation escalated yesterday right up to this moment.
Yes, thank you very much, Afu Stevens. My name's and I'm the president of the Presbyterian Education Authority Teachers Trade Union. And I would like to indicate to you that the teachers of Cameroon, especially of Anglophone extraction, have had a series of problems which we have been doing everything possible to table to government to handle, which the government has given a death year. And the issue started way back in 2007, even before then, that we realized that the Anglophone subsystem of education was being subjected to some specifications that were not in accordance with the Anglo-Saxon tradition. And it was compounded by the fact that the law of education, that is the law on orientation of education that was signed, was being abrogated. And this law actually had come out bringing the two systems of education distinct from each other. But what we were supposed to implement in the Anglophone sector has been cancelled with the introduction of other issues that are coming but from the Francophone subsystem. You realize that our system before had the 7 years at the primary level. We were pushed to cut it down to 6 years in the name of harmonization. And there was supposed to be a balance to at the level of secondary, which has not been done. And then there are many, many other issues that actually are affecting the system of education on the Anglophone part. Because we were deprived of technical education to way back when Ombe was closed down, and then they were introducing their CAP and probatoire that had no bearing on our own system. So we realized that some of these issues were actually putting us apart. So when we discover all this, we table our grievances to the government to see how. And government actually gave an accord. I remember in 2007, the Prime Minister actually indicated that the education forum for which we had been clamoring for should be convened by this present sitting Minister of Higher Education, which up to today he has not. We have held several meetings with him to see that the issues are handled, but he has given a death ear. So we thought that if we fold our arms and allow things, our brothers and sisters who are coming behind us will definitely be destroyed, because we discovered that they were sending Francophone teachers to come and teach Anglophone children using the French language, which they did not quite master, and the English language. So these are some of the issues that actually force us to regroup under the various trade unions to see how we could handle the matter. We have the Cameroon Teachers Association, the Teachers Association of Cameroon, the Presbyterian Education Authority Teachers Trade Union, for which I head, then the Baptist Teachers Trade Union, and the Catholics. So we came as a grouping. Also with the University of Yaoundé, of Boya, excuse me, that also has a syndicate on education. So these are the groupings that sat down and studied the documents, and we came out with our propositions to government on how this situation of education could be ameliorated. And not until we had put pressure on the government was a commission put in place for the issues to be studied. And the commission, to the best of our knowledge, did not reflect our aspirations. So when we were invited to Yaoundé for this meeting, we turned it down. And we turned it down on several scores of reasons. First, we said that the chairman of that commission, who is the present minister of higher education, was the person who was mandated to solve the problem. But he is the one who is instead causing those problems. So we refused that. He could not be the chairperson of that commission, and then the constitution too of the members was not to our liking. So on the Teachers' Day, October 5th, we had earlier announced to the government that we were going to go on an industrial strike if these issues were not taken into consideration for us to redress. But unfortunately, as government has always been intransigent to listen to people's cries, they allowed it not until we announced it. They were taking it for a joke, not until we announced that the strike was going to start on the 21st of November, which effectively started yesterday. And you are seeing the fallouts as a result of the strike action. So in the course of the launching of the strike yesterday, many other things happened. The governor first sent us words through somebody that they needed to hold a meeting with us. We refused to go first because all those who make up for the coalition of the trade unions, the coordination, were not present. Secondly, the invitation for us to come to that meeting was verbal, and it was coming from a source other than the governor and the minister. So we did not also, our security too was not guaranteed. So we stayed aloof. It is only when the governor now saw that things could not move well that he now extended an olive branch to the Archbishop of Bamenda, who used his office now to convene us to a meeting first at the bishop's house yesterday, where we discussed with them and tabled to them our grievances against government. So he broke out for peace and then indicated to the governor that he had talked with us and we were ready to meet the governor in their presence, together with the moderator of the Presbyterian Church in Cameroon. That is how we now went up to the station where we met the governor with the état major, and we discussed those issues. It was not again for us to be repeating things to the governor that we have repeated over the years. We now allowed the men of God to tell them what we had been telling them, which they listen now. We were thinking that from that angle now something was going to be done. But we are thankful that they were there, because the governor listened, and it is in that meeting that he now saw that the issues were serious, and he pledged and promised the church leadership of the Catholic and Presbyterian that he was going to do everything possible and within the shortest time possible to see that the issues are handled. So when we left from there, now we went to calm down the irate mob that was unquenched there, but we reached there and saw that the issues could not be handled because other persons had infiltrated. Our strike action actually was on the score that the parents should keep their children back at home, because the teachers will not go to school to dispense any lessons. I want to seize this opportunity to thank the parents who actually kept their children behind, and to thank the teachers who also respected the strike call and stayed. It is unfortunate that in such situations, some people now came in to magnify the situation, which was almost blame on us. But thank God we had already indicated that our strike is a sit-in strike. So what you saw happening in town, we're exonerated from it because we had earlier given that stand. Then to the other issue that I want to reflect on is that the guy who caused what is happening in Bamenda now had his own genuine concerns, which the people also took advantage, and we saw what is happening now. He prepared his coffin and said that he was going to attack, but the city council had destroyed the roads and with the Chinese company that was not taking care of the proper sanitation of the country, especially the Bamenda town. Mm-hmm. So in the course of this, the other people joined him, and that is how the issues escalated. I want to say that it is we cannot say that it is good, but it has played to our advantage, because some people who defied the instructions and were still sending their children to school finally realized that they were going out of the way with what happened the other way. So I want to think that it is a blessing in disguise that it has come to cause our strike to be totally respected, because the signals are there. Even when we were struggling to calm down the tempers of the protesters at the Nkwende with the governor present, there were other issues that were chained. They were just telling us how when they go to the hospitals, consultation is mostly in French that they do not understand. There were many, many other issues that are linked to this issue between the Anglophone and the Francophone. So we think that it is time for the government to actually put the two parties on a negotiating table for dialogue to take place so that the issues can be handled, without which we are afraid that we are sitting on a time bomb.
Thank you again for tuning in with Apex One Radio. Stay with us on www.apexoneradio.com. Apex One Radio, your radio.